Good evening, friends. The topic that we are going to talk right now about is what changes should come in Indian society. Changes because there's a lot of scope for betterment in our society, and we are here to give our view on what are the things that need a real change. So what are your views?
Yes, that.
Actually, numerous changes should come in Indian society. Firstly, I should tell you that so many changes have come. Like long before we had a patriarchal society, and then we had the joint family system, the very large, huge families living together. And nowadays we find the nuclear families with the husband, wife and their one or two kids living in the metro cities. The major changes that should come in Indian society are in marriages and their lust for the male child. Because till date, each and every family, almost in all parts of our country, they crave for the male child. So even if they have two or three girl childs, three daughters, they still keep on trying for a male child. And in this process, they neglect their girls. And then in marriages, still dowry is rampant. And in so many states of India, still we have the dowry deaths, the divorces and all that. So these are a few things I think they need the change right now.
Okay, who else?
Okay, you continue.
I think in the Indian society, the major change is about the gender roles, which needs to change. The particular stigma attached to what a particular gender should perform based on breadwinning or be it supporting the family. I think this concept needs a more liberal view. And also regarding the way we perceive, I think the superficial things such as money, materialistic things, and our view about the particular kinds of, maybe about children, the fields they follow. The Indian society needs to be more liberal about that, what their children want to do for their living, apart from the particular socially attached careers such as engineering or medicine.
Okay,
now let me add one a few more things. We still believe in a caste and religion. What's really surprising that even the most educated person, most educated class, even they believe in a caste and religion and this sort of attitude they have. They think in that way. And that is what I think one of the main reasons for dowry, big dowry. Always we have the, generally the parents, they think that their daughter should get married in a particular, whatever the caste they belong to. Or maybe the son should get married in the same caste. I think now the change should come. There should not be any caste or religion or anything. There should be freedom. The mind should set, set should be free. And everyone should be allowed to marry the caste in which they want to. That is the one thing. The second thing I would like to add, that we are still very superstitious, we Indians. We still believe that a black cat is crossing the road, then it is a bad omen. We still believe in an animal sacrifice. And then Nazar Lagna and all those things. Where we are. I think these sort of changes should come in Indian society. What do you feel? Yes.
I would like to add here that when a person dies in any family, till date the girl is not attached to anything. Did she not love her parents or her siblings? But here in Indian society, I have seen that if a person is dying, the daughter is completely removed from all the things that are going in the house. She can eat anything, she can attend parties, she can do anything. She is not entitled to follow all the norms that the boys of the family are following. Why? I really can't accept that. Here the fact of mukhagni, that the girls are not allowed to. It is a big deal if a girl is doing it. Why? She is also as much a daughter as the other of the family are. So yes, this is another point that I want to add. On a lighter vein, I want to add that Indians should stop spitting. This is one very bad habit that the Indian society has. They should stop spitting. They should stop eating in the most animalistic way that they can find. You will find in all the marriages, all the marriage ceremonies, people having their plate filled with different kinds of cuisines and they are eating like they have never eaten before. These things you will find only in an Indian society. So yeah, this is what is my take.
I think there are a few more things that need to be changed in Indian society. And the first and foremost is reservation system. Because that is really killing our
merit.
And the reservation system is completely based on caste and creed. And day after day, the reservation part has increased so much. Now the generals are the minority. And in the name of reservation, the very
affluent
ones get all the facilities. While they are studying, when they enroll in colleges, then they get their jobs. And really, it is very disheartening because if a very poor boy from a higher caste tries his level best to get into a college or he really does well, he doesn't get through because of just a meager 1 or 2% marks because he is of a higher caste. And the system that has been going on for so long is completely nonsense. Because if there is reservation, it should be based on income or the poverty, seeing how well off a person is, not the caste, what caste they belong to. And another thing the change should come in our society is the rituals and religious sentiments and all that fervor. Means the fanaticism. Because in the name of festivals, all the roads are blocked and people just waste their time not less than 3 or 4 days. They don't go to office, the schools are closed, the colleges are closed. Means the life just comes to a standstill on any Indian festival. So that does a big harm to our society and everything else.
Yes, one thing more I would like to add. That we Indians, we still believe in following the beaten path. You will find that it's still there is the craze of engineering. Everyone wants to send their son to the engineering field. Then there is the craze, of course, since medical is a costly field, but still there is a craze of medical and then the government job. It doesn't matter how talented you are, but you will find that always there is a more stress on the education instead of going in other way. I think that mind should change. The kids, whatever field they are good in, they should be encouraged and they should go in that. So regarding career, Indians should be more broad-minded and they should accept the changes that is coming in a modern world.
Exactly. What is your take?
I agree with all of you.
And
I've spoken what I wanted to.
Okay. Yeah, another thing that I think is that we are too much about degrees, certificate degrees,
exactly,
not
exactly.
Brain.
Yeah.
Every job that you go for asks you for a series of things, your qualifications, your work experience, but none of them are actually there to see whether you are worthy of it. Even if suppose you don't have that qualification, that degree, but you are far better than others, still you won't get a chance just because of a piece of paper.
Importance is not given to merit.
Exactly.
And one more thing is Barati dance. That was also one thing that only Indians have. So what is the logic behind dancing on the roads? Just because you are happy, you need to dance on the roads, burst crackers. Come on, grow up. Go to the venue. They have booked a DJ for you. There you can dance. So this is one more change that Indians should have. Okay, so what should we conclude?
Anything more you want to add?
No.
Fine, then you sum up.
So yes, Indians are very good at a huge lot of things like hospitality, like being really there for each other, having so many values, attachments, and yes, I'm very proud of it. But there is always the scope for a betterment and we hope that change comes. Thank you.